Thank you for the introduction. Today I'd like to talk about very interesting functional materials produced by iron oxide bacterium. The most people must have the experience to see this type of the brownish sediments or floats in a small stream, spring, and ditch, and sometimes in a drain pipe. When we take this sediment in a flask, we can like this, we can get orange color suspension here, and then under the microscope, we can find lots of the microtubule like this, and some empty and some filled with bacterium. Here, this is SEM image, and then the surface of this microtubule is composed of the woven microfibrils. Diameter is 1.25 to 1 micrometer, and the lengths range 50 to 100 micrometer, and sometimes a few thousand meter. And then here, this is the TEM image of the cross section of this the microtube, and then in this tube, the chained bacterial cells are enveloped with this electron dense wall. This bacteria is the genus Leptospirix. This is a bacterial cell, genus Leptospirix. This is a kind of the iron oxidizing bacterium. As I will tell you later, this wall material. That's okay. Sorry. The electron dense wall is composed of the iron oxides, very complex the iron oxide. Therefore, we named this wall biogenous iron oxides. We use the biox for abbreviation. So in my talk, I will use this biox or abbreviate when we talk about the biox, that means cease materials. Then TEM image of this bacterium associated cysts are quite different from the fixation method. Well, this image was obtained from the specimens fixed by conventional chemical fixation using the glutaraldehyde and osmium tetraoxide. Here, this is the bacterial cell, and then this hairy structure is the cyst. And between this structure, there is this intervening space. And this image was also observed, obtained from the specimen fixed with freeze substitution. Again here, this is bacterium cell and fibrous cyst, and then here it's an intervening space, but some microfibrils here. In both fixation method, we use organic solvents, ethanol or acetone, for specimen dehydration. So we assume that maybe these organic solvents cause a shrinkage of the this bacterial cell or leak out some microfibrils from this space. To verify our assumption, we applied a freeze fracture replica to observe the structure. Here, the image is completely different. This is a bacterial cell, and then this is the cis material here. Let's enlarge this part here. This is edge of the bacterium. And then from the outer surface of the bacterial, it's many, many nanoscale fibrils they are released. This is exopolymer, bacterial exopolymer. And then this fibril extended to form the cis. So this is a real image of the cis and the bacterium. So we learned that we must be very careful to catch the real image by electron microscopy. Oh. Then we moved to this topic, how the cis is formed bacterial cell. Then we use the one isolated strain of Leptospirix Ohm's 1 in the culture. This is the first, second, third day. And the first day, the bacterial cell release the exopolymer here. And the very thin cis, primitive cis is formed. So this is the role of the bacterial cell. Release the exopolymer to form the very thin cis material. Then second day and third day, the electron dense material attached to the outside of the this layer, and then thicken the cis layer thickened very much. And then we applied EDX to this site. And we found that iron, phosphorus, and silicon in these areas. So this bacteria works to form this. And then after that, the aqueous phase inorganics deposit to this layer. Then we wondered, these cis materials contain the organic components of bacterial origin or not. We applied alkaline bismuth stain to detect the polysaccharide. Here you can see the cytoplasmic membrane, also exopolymers, and primitive cis contain the polysaccharide. And this side, to detect the amino acids. Here, this is the DIC image, and then a positive response of the amino acid. So therefore, the cis materials apparently contain organic components of the of bacterial origin. Then we moved to detect some inorganics in this cis. This is SEM image, and here is the microtubule. This is analyzed point. Here we detected the iron phosphorus and silicon and also oxygen here. Oh. The approximate the atomic percent of iron, silicon, and phosphate in 75 to 20 to 5. So this ratio shows the elemental composition of groundwater. This ratio is 13, 14, and 1. So if compared with this ratio, it's very very clear that iron and silicon is selectively deposited to this structure. And by FTIR, we found these chemical linkage. So within a cis, the inorganic is not only deposited to form the chemical linkage. Then we applied electron energy loss spectroscopy to detect the distribution of iron and carbon and oxygen. So this is a single fibril, and this bright spot shows the distribution, the location of iron and oxygen and carbon. Here, this distribution pattern is very similar. This means that iron exists as iron oxide. But here, the carbon distribution is completely different from here. And then this image, it merged the image between iron and carbon. Here, green is the carbon, red is iron. So the fibrils, basic fibrils, basic cis texture, it are apparently organic, inorganic hybrid material. Well, in a water purifying the plant in Japan, sometimes the iron oxidizing bacteria are used to remove the iron from groundwater. Here, this water reservoir was filled with the groundwater. And then after several days, the water cleaned. Then after that, the clean water is gone. And then at the bottom of the reservoir, we get lots of the iron oxide, the complexes. The tons of the complexes on the reservoir bottom. And usually, we dispose this complexes by landfill. But our question is, are they really waste materials? The answer is no. The amazingly, very interesting functions of BIOXX we found, and like this, the pigment for property, pottery, cell culture enhancer, or another material for battery, plant protectant, and plant growth enhancer. Is the time is so limited, I will explain these three as an example. So ceramic artists always seek the bright color, color pigment that is grazes like this. And then, this is the color of the natural BIOXX. This like kind of yellowish orange, but heating this natural product 700 to 1,000, the color would gradually change. And then here, this graph showed that this is a degree of the yellowish color, this is a degree of reddish. Here, it is unheated one. This one is the color is here, low yellow and reddish here. But 800 degrees gave the very strong reddish and yellowish, very bright grays for ceramics work. And another way, in culture, we found that if we cultured an isolated strain at low pH and with carbon dioxide, yellow color is also obtained. So now it's many ceramic artists are interested in to use this the bioproduct. And then Biox promotes 3D growth of animal cells in culture. That we use a breast cancer cell. This is a cell cluster at day 6, and then day 10, it's increased, its size is increased rapidly. This graph showed how the cell cluster diameter increased. This here, the size is very slowly increased if the biox is not present here. But if we use the biox, the size increases rapidly like this. This is SEM. This is small microtubule biox. Here is the cell cluster. So we assume that biox microtubule gives a route of oxygen or nutrients to the individual cells. So 3D cell culture cluster is very, very useful for production of specific proteins like albumin or drug screening. So I think that this is another interesting the function. Then we learned in the culture, the silicon content in the medium affects AP-SE ratio of biox. Here we use the iron coupon, and silicon contents change to 0 to 300 ppm. For example, if we don't use the silicon, of course, the atomic percent of the biox is 100%. But now, here, if this silicon increases to 300 ppm, this ratio becomes the 50-50. So learning from this result, we attempted to synthesize new oxidizers linked with varied amounts of silicon by artificial techniques with expectation to create novel function materials. Here, this is the artificial protocol, iron nitrate and sodium silicate mixed. And then pH, after pH adjustment, reaction, the product is washing and vacuum dried. Here, in artificial product also, the silicon is not here, not included. The of course, the silicon content in this two-line ferrihydrate is very low. But if this ratio increases to 0.3, the silicon content include this. The crystallinity changes from low crystallinity to amorphous when the silicon increases. So we got this type of the artificial products. And then before, we knew that BIOCs promote the chemical reaction. So this is the example, cyclohexanone to epsilon caprolactone here, and we added the BIOCs here. Then natural BIOCs, the yield of 2, that means caprolactone, is about this level, 45%. But if we use the artificial the iron oxide, including containing 40 to 50% of the silicon, the yield increase like this. So silicon content 40 to 50 atomic percent showed maximum yield of caprolactone. So I think the BIOCs promote many other chemical reactions. But the mechanism is still unknown, but it seems likely that a very complex combination, silicon and iron, is very important to promote this reaction. So this is my conclusion of my talk. So basic texture of BIOCs produced by genus Leptosyrix is composed of unique, ingenious organic, organic, inorganic hybrid materials. The second is BIOCs materials have diverse attractive functions for industrial purposes. But still, mechanism is in investigation. And then the last one is very important, basic knowledge of BIOCs. For example, structure, component, formation process, etc., benefits creation of novel functional materials for human life by artificial synthesis process. Thank you for your attention.